In this lesson, we're going to learn how to create and set projects in Houdini. Now, when you start creating scenes and working in Houdini, and you want to save your work, you can just go File, Save As, and pretty much put your work anywhere you want to go. It's fairly open and fluid when you first open Houdini. If you want to organize yourselves a little bit more, the other option is to create a project. So you can go File, New Project. You'll see this window here where you can say I'm going to create a test project in this folder called Houdini Projects. Here's some subdirectories, things that will allow me to store geometry, digital assets, textures, renderings, and so on, and say accept to create that new directory. Now when you've got your object and you want to go File, Save As, you can just go into here and you'll see that we're inside Test Project. And we can save that right here, so we can go box.hip. So that's where we'll save our file, and those other subdirectories could be used if we were rendering, and so on and so forth. Now, if we were going to set an existing project, let's do that. We're going to go File, Set Project, and we're going to, there's Test Project, so we're going to go up one level, and we're going to pick the Squab Project. We're going to accept. And now we're going to go File, Open, and we're going to go into the Squab project and pick the Squab scene. Now, when you do this, the way to find this project is $job is the quick way to do it. So if you were, let's say, somewhere else and you wanted to quickly find your project, you just go $job gets you to your project. Select that and go Accept. So here we have a scene with an object in it. And we'd like to assign a texture to that. So we're going to go to the material palette. We're going to take a mantra surface material, drag it over here, go to there. We're going to use a texture map, and we're going to get one. Now, we've got this project here, so let's make sure we do $job. There was a $job reference up there. Go texture, and the diffuse map is right here. And what you'll see is it uses that $job reference in there. To set up your texture. And the reason you want to do this is this keeps all of your on-disk references local to the project you're working on, and you're ready to go. Now if we take Mantra Surface and drag that over, assign material, there we go. Now as you build up your scene, all of your elements should be existing within these project directories, and they all should be referenced using this $job reference here. Now, if you want to check to see if that's the case, what you can do is under Render, we've got an option called Preflight, and this will actually go through, and you can say reference it based on $job, and you get this window here. And what we see is that in this case here, the Squab Diffuse texture is green because it was referenced properly, but the geometry, the Squab geometry, was actually done using a $home, so it's actually local to the computer, and if I was to pick this whole project and share it with someone else, this wouldn't work properly. So we want to fix that. So we're going to click on this, and we're going to fix the expression by going in and just going up to that point there, $job, and go accept. Now you'll see that part's green, and we're ready to go. So in here, you'll actually see there's the geometry, there's the material. So if we go to the back to the object level, dive in to the geometry, you'll see that now it's been updated to say $job. So everything that we do is related to this $job value, which is defined when you set the project. So I hope this has given you a quick idea of how to create a project, how to set a project, and then use the $job reference to make sure any geometry or textures that you're feeding into the scene stay connected even when you share with other people.